أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فويل للذين يكتبون الكتاب بأيديهم ثم يقولون هذا من عند الله ليشتروا به ثمنا قليلا فويل لهم مما كتبت أيديهم وويل لهم مما يكسبون قال رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي Respected viewers, listeners, today the subject is What is Bible? The ayah in the beginning was from Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah number 2, ayat number 79. Allah says, فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَكْتُبُونَ الْكِتَابَ بِأَيْدِيهِمْ ثُمَّ يَقُولُونَ هَذَا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ Woe to them who write down the book with their own hands and then they say, this is from Allah. Allah is responsible. لِيَشْتَرُوا بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا So they can mint some money from it. فَوَيْلٌ لَهُمْ مِمَّا كَتَبَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ So woe to them what they're Hands do right, وَوَيْلُ لَهُمْ مِمَّا يَكْسِبُونَ And woe to them what they earn through it. Surah number 2, ayat number 79. This lecture of mine has been divided into three parts. Number 1, what is Bible? Number 2, who are the authors of the Bible? Number 3, the versions of the Bible. We will discuss all of three parts. What is Bible? What is it? Bible is actually the Greek word coming from Biblos. They cut the end of the os, retained Bible in a short form. Now they put the holy before Bible. Word holy Bible is not to be found in the Bible. Bible doesn't name itself. And the word literal meaning of Biblos is the collection of the books, encyclopedias. Whereas Holy Quran names itself. Allah says in Surah Rahman, chapter 51, verse 1 and 2. Ar-Rahman, Allah al-Quran. Rahman, the merciful God, has taught you the Quran. Khalq al-Insan, who has created you. Allah al-Bayan, who has taught you the use of utterance. So Ar-Rahman, God Almighty, is naming the Holy Quran, whereas Bible doesn't name itself. This is the literal meaning of the Bible. Now, the Bible has been divided into two parts, Old Testament and the New Testament. Old Testament belongs to Judeo-Christians and the New Testament belongs to Christians only, not Jews. Jews are not accepting the New Testament as a canonized book. So, New Testament means the testimony after the birth of Jesus Christ. And before Jesus Christ, from Adam to before Jesus Christ is called Old Testament, the records of those prophets. Now the concept of the Holy Quran and Islam, we are told in Islam, the concept, the book which was given to Moses is called Torah, singular. The book which was given to David, Zabur, singular. The book which was given to Jesus, Injil. Singular, and the book which was given to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, singular. Singular, singular, singular. But when you people are being asked the question of these records of the Holy Quran, you are telling that you got different books in your Bible. Jews are telling us that you got five books, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, as a Torah, which is Torahs, not Torah. So this Torahs are contradictory to the Quranic statement. And similarly, Zabur you are talking about, Quran says the Zabur was a revelation responsible by David only. But in your case, Zabur has been shared between two writers or three writers, Solomon and David, peace be upon them all. This is what your people are telling, your scholars are telling. Now let us discuss about these, the books which you call. So first five books are Torah, meaning laws. You are telling us Moses wrote it. Second book, the middle of them are called the historical books in your Bible. Besides the Zabur, book of Psalms. Then you got Old Testament, Matthew, Mark, Luke and John, four Gospels. Similarly, Quran never mentioned about the four Gospels. Quran says Isa, Injil Isa. You haven't got it. Second part of the subject, who are the authors of the Bible? In generally, people, they think that the first five books are Torah. These five books is Torah. Now, when we evaluate and when we scrutinize them, you will not find these things. Look, first five books, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. More than 700 times we are told in the Old Testament, the statements like this are framed up. And Lord spoke to Moses and Moses spoke to Lord. Now we can sense that neither Moses is writing nor Lord is dictating. Because more than 700 times. Because if Moses would have written it, Moses would say, and Lord spoke to me and I spoke to Lord. If God was writing, then God said, I spoke to Moses and Moses replied me. But we can sense the third person is writing. So your document is weak. If you take the glass of water and you put one tiny droplet of urine in the water, the whole water will be contaminated. If you got one evidence, one small evidence which is weak, even if it is a trivial evidence, your document is weak. It must be scrutinized. Then we're talking about the book of Psalms. You got more than 100 chapters over there. Nobody knows who is the right author. But your scholars are telling us that book of Psalms is also being shared between two writers, David and Solomon. So you got confusion. Then the historical books which nobody talks. Book of Kings, unknown authors. Samuel, unknown authors. Unknown authors you got in your Bible. One drop of a urine is enough to contaminate whole the bucket of the water. Now let us come to the New Testament which you're talking about. New Testament. Matthew, Mark, Luke and John. Matthew was neither the disciple of Jesus Christ. I will explain why. Matthew. Mark, not the disciple of Jesus. Luke was not the disciple of Jesus. John was not the disciple of Jesus. So far, so good. Now you read Matthew. We can see the internal evidence of Matthew, Mark, Luke and John. These Gospels are not responsible by their writers because they didn't sign their names. If Matthew didn't sign his name. And Mark, Luke and John were not even the disciples. Matthew is the nearest. But we can sense that Matthew, the real Matthew is not this writer. The Gospel of Matthew which you are reading. The church canonized it. Now you read Matthew 9:9. Over there we find the statement about Matthew. That the verse is this. Goes like this. The Bible. Matthew chapter 9 verse 9 says. And Jesus saw the tax collector by the name of Matthew, and he came to Matthew, and he said to Matthew, Matthew, stand up. And Matthew stood. He said, follow me. So Matthew followed him. We can say that the third person is writing. Because if Matthew would have written, he must say that, and Jesus saw me. I was sitting on the tax collector table. So Jesus saw me, and he said to me, Matthew, stand up. And I stood up. And he told me, follow me, and I followed him. This is the right English. You Americans, you Britishers, you taught us English. When you conquered our land, when you captured our land, you taught us English. Now you explain the grammar of the English, please. Or brainwash us, reprogram us. You explain to us, who is writing? The third person? Who? So Matthew didn't write these statements. Impossible. Now you read Mark chapter 16 verse number 9 to 20 has been thrown out as a fabrication, interpolation, adulteration, concoction, prostitution. These whole passage has been taken out as a fabrication. One drop of a urine is enough to contaminate the whole bucket of water. One drop of urine. You got one smudge which is not supposed to be there in the word of God. Then this in the total per se totality, Bible is not the word of God. Simple. So RSV Revised Standard Version, they took all the passage out. And in the new versions, New International Version, you will not find these passages. These passages are in the footnotes now. Then footnote is not the part of the Bible. Ask anyone, any scholar. Now let us come to Luke. Luke chapter 24, verse 51. And Jesus was ascended into heaven, taken out as a fabrication, concoction in your RSV version. One verse is enough. Now you read fourth gospel, John. This fourth gospel was already under disputation. And after several decades, they brought this gospel as canonized. There was only three gospel, deuterocanonical gospel, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John was added later. Why? Because the Constantine, 325 AD, this guy was a philosopher, and he was a mushrik, pagan, just like a Cyrus, in the book of Isaiah. And this guy, he wanted to love these people, he was looking at these people, and I can rule them in the Constantine, and this Turkey, Istanbul, is named under his name. Constantinople. So he converted himself as a camouflage in a deceptive way to win the hearts of the people. Then he thumbs up and put all these pagans theologies of the Grecians and put it into the Christianity. And he made this Jesus, Son of God, democratically by the show of hands, nominated Jesus as God. And the gospels who were being circulated, which goes against the grain of this Constantine and the people who got Trinitarians against, they just burned it, they threw it away, and the church finalized the gospels and they gave to the people. You want to accept it or just go to hell. This is how they did it. But when you talk about the Holy Quran was learnt by the disciples of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, himself. And it was among the people, not under the secret custody or underground custody. And 114 surahs was left over by the ijma consensus of the sahabas at the time of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, and at the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam too, and at the time of Hazrat Usman radiyallahu anhu. The Quran was being compiled in a book form, which was left over 114 surahs. None of them have been changed. And the miracle of the Quran is read that the little child knows the Quran by heart, and he can rattle the whole Quran without even a symbol, like a tiny mistake of the vowels. He can rattle whole the Quran. But when you talk about your versions, I'm coming to that, the third part of the subject. I will tell you how many versions you got, then how you can memorize it. When you don't even have one unity of the Bible, you can't memorize. So, when we talk about the John, the fourth gospel, we read the eternal evidence. Last chapter of the gospel, last chapter of this John gospel, over there it is written. And this is the testimony of John. This is the testimony of John. Or this was the testimony of John, who is writing that statement. One drop of urine is enough to contaminate the bucket of water. One drop of the urine. So John is also not responsible. Now coming to Paul, 27 books he wrote it. Paul was not even the disciple of Jesus. His doctrine is going against all the doctrine of the Jesus Christ and previous prophets. His doctrine. Trinity, Jesus rose from the dead. These all things, this Paul guy, he is introducing in the Christendom. And Barnabas, if you remember in the book of Acts, Barnabas was reluctant to join hands with this Paul. Barnabas was reluctant. Why? Because he knew and he knows that this guy is making a fuss, is going to create fuss. That is what Allah says in the Holy Quran, Surah Al Imran, chapter 3, verse 51 onwards. Allah said, at the time of Jesus Christ, Jesus asked to his disciples, who will support me? Who will support me to worship one thy Lord? So his old disciples said, we are Muslims. Allah said they are Muslims, and they supported Jesus. And Allah says that, oh Jesus, your supporter will be prevailed over the disbelievers till the day of judgment. Your followers will prevail. Now what does follower means? To accept you as your right ethic and the status. Accept you as the right attitude of your stature, that you are the messenger of God, no other than the messenger of God. So on that basis, if you read that verse, it is talking about the Islam. Because Islam is only the non-Christian faith, which makes it an article of faith, that Jesus is Christ, Messiah, he who is born blind with the lepers, by God's permission, quickened the dead, by God's permission. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam accepted his right stature, and this is what Allah said, I will give them the victory over the disbeliever forever. And after the 80 years of the demise of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Islam conquered every nation on earth because they were accepting the right stature of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. Allah promised Jesus, whosoever will follow you on the right direction, I will prevail them. I will make them to prevail. So Muslims did it and they prevailed. So John, Mark, Luke, Matthew, all of them are under scrutinization. Paul, leave out the Paul. Paul has no place in the house of Islam. No documentation on the Paul he can entitle to get some space or vacancy. No documentation in from the house of Islam. Paul has no space, no vacancy for Paul. Now coming to the third part, versions of the Bible. In general, when we talk to the Christians, they say we have the one version of the Bible. Only one version of the Bible. Tyndale version, Wycliffe version, Durham's version, Roman Catholics, Durham's, and this King James version. Fifth major revision of King James version is going on. What you are talking to me? You are making versions, and by God, every Bible is different. They are not talking about the choice of words and making. There are two kinds of abrogation in Christendom regarding the Bible from the beginning. Two kinds of abrogation. Remember that. Number one, the abrogation of the words, and number the abrogation of the meanings. They did it both. They changed the meanings too. For example, the Orthodox Jews or the Orthodox Christians, they got different translation of Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6. You read Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6, Christians translated it that the son will be born who will call the everlasting father, the prince of peace. Now similarly, the same verse has been translated by Jews in their translation of English translation. They translated the everlasting father. Everlasting Father, not to the Son, the Everlasting Father, who will give the Prince of Peace. You see the difference? This is called, you call it deception. Now Christian, they are making their own translation. Now the other sect of the Christian, he will make his own translation. And not the choice of words, they will remove the words, they will add the words. The prophecies of Islam, they are changing it day by day. They are removing it. The prophecies of Islam from the Bible, they are removing it. The prophecy of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, they are removing it. Talking about Allah, the moon god, Allah, the moon god. You read the Arabic Bible, the first verse of the Arabic says Allah. You, the Urdu Pakistanis Christians, you are saying, playing the snake tricks in Pakistan. You are telling us that Allah is the moon god, Allah is the moon god. You see your Urdu Bible, the first verse says Allah. What you are talking about? And you Americans, you civilized people went to the moon. Went to the moon. You couldn't scrutinize your own Bible, but you went to the moon. Congratulations. Now you went to the moon, but you are translating the word of God. Say God. In the beginning, God created that. God is the title. God is not the name. Mr. is the title. Mr. is not the name. You can call Mr. to anyone. What is the name of God? What is the name of God? Jesus? No. Elohim. Elohim in Hebrew, Allah, Allahim. So you don't know. You are reading the Eastern book with the Greek glasses or the Western glasses, and you are making all this hodgepodge, conundrum, and enigma. So how many versions you got? Unlimited. Day by day, by God, day by day, new versions are coming. You know, just like mushrooms are sprouting out in a season, or a frog in a rainy season. That is the way you are making your own Bibles. New translation version, NIV Bible, Neighbor Bible. Amazing names. I even can't remember the names. How you can memorize the Bible by heart? How? In Islam, we have sects too. I don't say that we don't have sects in Islam, denominations, which you Jews gave it to us, the gift of division. Allah says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 103, وَعَتَسِمُ بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold the rope of Allah altogether and don't get divided among yourselves. So you Jews did a good job. When you're living in the midst of us, you played tricks against the Muslims to divide them. Similarly, you played the tricks in the Christian time in the Middle Ages, in 15th or 16th century, Calvin and Martin, they both made the people to protest against the Pope, because Pope was not allowing them to use usury interest. So they want to introduce the banking system, so they said, protest against the Pope, he will not let you to use of a usury. So they protested against him, and they made their own theology and philosophy by the name of Protestantism. We protested against the Pope, we don't want to follow that Pope, Baba. So they did it, and they made the first Bank of England, and the sous and the usury, all the haram things were introduced in Christendom. And those people went to America, Columbus, the Protestant world America, and that is why these people are, you know, supporting Israel. As you got the statements that America is a dog and Israel is tail. Wheresoever tail wags, America goes there. You find these things in the literature. That is why they're supporting. But when you ask the Pope, he hates Israel. He doesn't love Israel by his heart. Now they're exaggerating the history nowadays. This Pope is exaggerating the history, but unbroken speakers of Pope, they never allow any people to love these Jews. And these Roman Catholic people, on every Easter, they killed the Jew. On every Easter, they said, these people are our Lord killer. They kill our Lord, kill them, burn them, hang them over the tree. This is what they're doing, these regular churchgoers, passive resistance Christians. So, they can do to us too. We are human beings too. So they did it. They brought up puppets who can, you know, change their Islam, who can make us to talk into trivial stuff. So they did it. But the nutshell for all this story is, after doing this all, we are following one Quran with 114 surahs. That is the heart of the matter. But your case is different. You got 66 books of Protestantism world, you thrown out the books too, besides the several other issues. And Roman Catholics got 73 or 70, more than 73 books. Orthodox Jews have some else books. This is the way you people are compiling your Bible. So Bible is not one book. So when you talk about the Holy Quran, that Holy Quran says that in Surah Maidah chapter 5 verse 48, that Holy Quran is protecting the Bible. It's a lie. Which Bible you are talking about? Quran is protecting the Roman Catholic version or your Protestant version? Huh? Which version? Bell and Dragon? Tobias? Which books are protecting? Bell and Dragon? Can you sense the name of the book? Bell and Dragon? The Roman Catholics? I'm talking to Roman Catholic. Or you Protestant, Quran is protecting the Book of the Kings, unknown author? We invite you towards the house of Islam. Please scrutinize your Bible and you will see that where truth lies. Quran is the book which came down, and since it has not been changed yet, not even a smudge has been changed. How come? Is it the coincidence for 1400 years? And Allah says in Surah Maidah chapter 5 verse number 82 that the nearest among you, O Muslims, you will find Christians, because they are not arrogant. Some of them are not arrogant. They are conquering the world. They are understanding. Allah says you will find them in love, Christians. But Allah says Jews will never love you. Now for 1400 years Jews are reading the Quran. They can easily turn the table and they can love us by showing that Quran is false. But they never did it. How come? How come? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, a day will come when even the stone will cry that Jew is hiding behind me. Get him, get him. But except the tree of Gharqad. Gharqad will protect them. But Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam never says that kill a Christian, hiding behind the stones. Only Jew. And these Jews messed up all of the world, even the Christians too. But you people are not seeing that. You people are blind. And Antichrist is the personality which is against the Christians and the Muslims. Remember that. But it will support Jews, Antichrist, because they will think that there is the Messiah. We believe Christ, we are not Antichrist. You Christians are not Antichrist. But your dogma is wrong in understanding the stature of Jesus. But Jews who rejected him totally, you are supporting them and you are saying that we are Antichrist. This is very unjust, by God, very unjust. Accept the tree of Gharqad. And now, because of that hadith, Israel. In Israel, the fastest growing seeding cultivation, you will find the tree of Harakat, box thorn tree. They are doing it because they know the what Prophet Muhammad said, it will going to happen soon. وَآخِرُ الدَّعْوَانَ عَنِ الْحَمْدِ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ